Dina, it's been just shy of a week since 15th Ward Alderman Raymond Lopez voiced strong objections to the proposed city payout. Now, in a tweet, Lopez saying, quote, "There is no way in hell that I'm voting to give $1.2 million to the estate of a coked-out gangbanger that died resisting arrest." And today at City Council, Lopez doubling down on his objection.
We have to send a message. We have to stand up and fight not only the criminals on the streets, but the criminals in the courts when they try to sue us for money for the bad behavior and the terror that they have inflicted on the 77 communities we all represent.
An emotional Raymond Lopez voicing his displeasure with a vote to approve a $1.2 million settlement on a wrongful death lawsuit. A lawsuit filed by the family of the late Heriberto Godinez, the family contending that a 2015 Brighton Park burglary arrest went dangerously wrong. Lawyers for the family conceding that the 26-year-old Godinez overdosed on cocaine and also showed signs of alcohol poisoning in autopsies, but Godinez's family pointing to police stepping on the man's neck as a contributing factor to his death. An autopsy ordered by the family's lawyer finding Godinez died of asphyxia with abrasions to his neck and damage to his carotid artery. Now, some on the City Council Finance Committee voting with reservations about the controversial matter.
The cost of trying it for us would outweigh the cost of the settlement offer, and so that's what I've struggled with.
I had a 21-year-old shot dead in a car she was driving with by gang members associated with this individual.
No opportunity for the Godinez family to react to Lopez's words. This settlement isn't a done deal just yet. The full City Council has to vote to approve this payout next week. At City Hall, Julian Cruz, WGN News.
Julian, thank you.